We are ready to go. As you can see, we are on site, so the tents are coming up. We are expecting a crowd as usually because of the limited seating space, around 4,000 or 4.5, 6, 5, 4 to 5 maximum. I think we have them here. The Minister of State will be reading His Excellency's address on this auspicious day. Also in attendance will be the families of national heroes that are buried in Bulawayo. The 15 national heroes who are buried in Bulawayo, their families will be here. They are being hosted by Minister of Home Affairs at Holiday Inn. And then this day starts with the Minister of State and Joko joining them on a tour of the national hero place. After which they will come and join us here at the provincial hero zeka. And the hero zeka will have families of those heroes buried here. They will sit in their own special tent, with their own special arrangements. Traditionally, we would then host them in the large city hall. But this is a year where we are dealing with issues to do with cholera, and we are minimizing cooking. But still, they will be fed separately. There will be quite a bit of entertainment. We have lined up 4 or 5 groups in accordance with the theme of the day. Some of the entertainers are actually liberation war heroes who are going to sing, others to do poetry. On this day, when they remember some of their colleagues from the liberation struggle. At the end of the day, this is one of the most important days. It's about this. Where we commemorate those who paid the ultimate sacrifice. Those who went out to take all the risks and liberate the country. Of course, working with the rest of the populace. But there are those who were actually out there in the bush, who went out to trade and came back and engaged militarily with the enemy. So this is a day when we remember them. It's a day when Zimbabwe remembers that it came out of a protracted struggle, which lasted upwards of 14 years. So that is those are the arrangements for tomorrow. Then the day after that, we have Defense Forces Day, where we remember first the integration of different forces that happened in 1980 into a Zimbabwe National Army that we see today, that is our pride as a nation. And the things that they have achieved over the years, besides having many of the senior ones having been participating in the liberation, post-independence, Zimbabwe has contributed a lot to peace in the world, including serving on UN missions, including crossing the border and assisting with problems in the SADC region to resolve those. So this is the day. So we'll be at White City, not here, we'll be at White City Stadium, where we'll have the usual very popular military displays accompanying the festivities, lots of entertainment, and in the afternoon we'll have some sporting activities. But there's also the awarding of medals by His Excellency the President through the Minister of State to 200 recipients in the various categories. Some of them are all veterans, others are non-combatant cadres, some of them are former detainees, and so forth and so on. So these will also be given medals on this auspicious day. Thank you very much.
Siabong.